Welcome to the Fix Sleep Bedtime Stories Channel, your sanctuary for relaxation, meditation, and a peaceful sleep. Immerse yourself in the soothing embrace of sleep-inducing tales, carefully crafted to transport you to mysterious lands. Let the gentle rain and serene sounds of nature accompany you on this journey to relaxation. Say goodbye to restless nights and welcome the embrace of a restful sleep with our magical sleep stories. So, let the tale begin. The Silver Palace of Leprechauns. Chapter 1. The Silver Palace's Secret. In the heart of the ancient forest, where the shadows played with the moonbeams, there stood the Silver Palace, a celestial masterpiece woven from moonlight and adorned with stones that sparkled like stars. The air surrounding the palace was filled with a serene hum, a harmonious melody resonating from the very heart of the woodland realm. The leprechauns, guardians of the mystical palace, moved gracefully amidst the glow, preparing for one of their legendary celebrations. With each twirl, their emerald green attire shimmered, reflecting the ethereal light that emanated from the palace. Their laughter, akin to the tinkling of wind chimes, echoed through the majestic trees, alerting the woodland creatures to the festivities about to unfold. Among the leprechauns, a young and enchanting woman named Róisín stood at the edge of the clearing, captivated by the radiant allure of the Silver Palace. Her eyes, the color of the midnight sky, sparkled with curiosity and wonder. She had heard tales of this magical place, stories whispered by the ancient oaks and sung by the babbling brooks that surrounded her village. Róisín, with her auburn hair cascading like a waterfall down her shoulders, moved with hesitant steps toward the luminous structure. The moonlight wove through the leaves overhead, casting a gentle glow upon the moss-covered path leading to the palace. As she approached, the air seemed to carry whispers of enchantment, a beckoning call that invited her to partake in the otherworldly revelry. The Silver Palace, with its ethereal spires reaching towards the heavens, loomed larger as she drew nearer. The stones that composed its walls pulsed with a soft luminescence, reminiscent of a lullaby whispered by the night itself. Intricate carvings adorned the palace's facade, depicting the tales of ancient spirits and the dance of constellations in the cosmic tapestry above. Upon detecting Róisín's arrival, the leprechauns gave her a friendly smile and held out their hands to embrace. When she stepped inside the Hall of Stars, their laughing surrounded her in a symphony of joy. The interior of the palace was a work of art, lit by a gentle silver radiance. The ceiling was covered in crystals of all sizes, which caused the moonlight to be refracted and dance across the walls in a rainbow of hues. Róisín marveled at the scene unfolding before her. The leprechauns, in their radiant splendor, began to orchestrate the preparations for the grand celebration. Tables adorned with glistening delicacies appeared, and the air filled with the aroma of enchanted nectar and ambrosial treats. As the festivities commenced, the moon peeked through the branches, casting its silver rays onto the dance floor. The leprechauns, with nimble footwork, twirled and whirled, creating a mesmerizing spectacle that seemed to transcend the earthly realm. Róisín, drawn into the rhythmic enchantment, felt the magic of the Silver Palace seeping into her very soul. unbeknownst to her, the woodland spirit, a silent observer cloaked in moonlight, watched Róisín with an intensity that mirrored the sparkle of the stars. The spirit, intricately entwined with the magic of the forest, recognized in Róisín a kindred spirit, an adventurer, a seeker of the extraordinary. As the night unfolded, the Silver Palace became a nexus of celestial energy, and Róisín, guided by the whispers of the ancient trees, began her journey into the heart of the woodland enchantment, the revelry, a mere prelude to the mysteries that awaited, set the stage for the captivating adventures that would soon enthrall her in the magical embrace of the Silver Palace. Chapter 2, Moonlit Allure. As the Silver Palace's enchanting festivities continued, Róisín found herself twirling in tandem with the leprechauns, her steps guided by the celestial rhythm echoing through the luminous hall. The moonlight streamed through the crystal-adorned windows, casting a kaleidoscope of colors on the polished floor. In the midst of the captivating dance, Róisín's gaze was drawn to the woodland spirit, a figure cloaked in the silvery glow of moonbeams. His eyes, pools of ancient wisdom, met hers, sparking a connection that transcended spoken words. The allure of the moonlit palace and the mysterious spirit became an irresistible force, weaving an invisible thread that bound Róisín to the heart of the woodland magic. The leprechauns, with their mischievous grins and twinkling eyes, guided Róisín and the other revelers through the celestial dance. As the tempo increased, the air crackled with magic, and unseen forces propelled the dancers into a whirlwind of ethereal movement. The walls of the Silver Palace seemed to dissolve, revealing hidden passages that led to realms unknown. Róisín, carried by the enchantment, found herself in a moonlit corridor adorned with ancient tapestries depicting forgotten tales. The woodland spirit, silent and ethereal, extended his hand, beckoning her to follow. Without hesitation, she embarked on a journey beyond the confines of the palace, stepping into a dimension where time and space intertwined. The moonlit allure guided Róisín through portals concealed within the fabric of reality. In an instant, she stood atop a moonlit hill, surrounded by meadows bathed in celestial glow. The fragrance of blossoms unseen wafted through the air as the spirit led her towards a silver lake that mirrored the star-studded sky above. As they approached the water's edge, the moon's reflection rippled, revealing ancient prophecies written in the language of the cosmos. The spirit pointed to constellations overhead, unraveling stories of celestial beings who had witnessed the birth of worlds and the weaving of fate. Róisín, with wide-eyed wonder, absorbed the cosmic tales that echoed in the gentle ripples of the lake. The journey continued through moonlit glades and ethereal groves, each step revealing a new facet of the woodland magic. In a hidden garden, luminescent flowers bloomed, their petals exuding melodies that resonated with the heartbeat of the universe. Róisín, enraptured by the symphony of nature, felt the pulse of life entwining with the rhythm of her own heart. The woodland spirit, a silent guide through the moonlit odyssey, led Róisín to an ancient observatory nestled among celestial peaks. Telescopes carved from enchanted wood pointed towards distant galaxies, and the spirit whispered tales of stardust and cosmic secrets that had been witnessed through the ages. As the moonlight painted a celestial canvas above, Róisín and the woodland spirit soared through the skies on wings woven from moonbeams. They traversed astral realms, encountering ethereal beings that shimmered like stardust. The spirit revealed the interconnectedness of all things, the cosmic dance that bound every entity in the tapestry of existence. The moonlit allure, ever present and guiding, brought Róisín back to the Silver Palace. The dance continued, yet she felt a profound transformation within. The woodland spirit, having shared the secrets of the cosmos, faded into the moonlit shadows, leaving Róisín with the echo of celestial melodies and the wisdom of ages. As the revelry reached its crescendo, Roisin's eyes reflected the moonlit allure that now resided within her soul. The Silver Palace, a nexus of magic and mystery, had become a part of her, and the moonlit adventure had unveiled the cosmic tapestry that connected her earthly existence to the celestial wonders that danced above. The allure of the moonlit palace and the enigmatic spirit that guided her had forever altered the course of Róisín's journey into the heart of the woodland enchantment. Chapter 3, Enchanted Odyssey. As the moonlit allure of the Silver Palace continued to cast its spell, Róisín found herself once again amidst the leprechauns, their twinkling eyes reflecting the mystique of the night. The woodland spirit, having vanished into the moonlit shadows, left behind a lingering sense of ethereal connection that pulsed within her very being. The enchanting festivities evolved into a new phase as the leprechauns orchestrated the opening of hidden portals within the Silver Palace. These portals, concealed behind shimmering tapestries and veils of moonlight, beckoned the revelers to embark on an odyssey through realms unseen by mortal eyes. Róisín, her heart infused with the celestial energies of the moonlit palace, felt a pull towards a particular portal, its glow reminiscent of the star-studded night sky. With each step towards the unknown, a cascade of vivid images unfolded, unveiling realms untouched by time. The first portal transported the leprechauns and Róisín to a sunlit meadow bathed in golden hues. This meadow, nestled between rolling hills and ancient ruins, echoed with the laughter of invisible nymphs. The air buzzed with whispers of forgotten tales as the leprechauns led Róisín through an archway adorned with intertwined vines. As they traversed the enchanted meadow, they stumbled upon a pool of liquid silver surrounded by iridescent butterflies. The pool revealed glimpses of the past, present, and future, as if the liquid silver held the collective memories of the woodland realm. Róisín gazed into its depths, captivated by the swirling visions that unfolded like chapters in an ancient tome. The next portal opened into a moonlit glade, where an ethereal stag with antlers adorned in constellations grazed peacefully. The leprechauns, with mischievous smiles, handed Róisín a silver harp that seemed to resonate with the music of the cosmos. As she played, the glade transformed into a celestial ballroom, and stardust-draped spirits joined in a dance that transcended the boundaries of time. From there, the Odyssey led them to an underwater cavern adorned with luminescent seaweed and guarded by mermaids with sapphire tails. The mermaids, singing tales of sunken kingdoms and forgotten treasures, gifted Róisín a seashell necklace infused with the power of the ocean depths. As she donned the necklace, the cavern walls shimmered, revealing an intricate map of underwater realms waiting to be explored. The Odyssey continued through ancient forests where sentient trees whispered secrets of forgotten alliances between spirits and creatures. Róisín touched the bark of an ancient oak, and visions of bygone eras flooded her senses. The leprechauns, with knowing smiles, guided her through the heart of the forest, where hidden doorways opened into realms untouched by sunlight. Róisín and her otherworldly companions found themselves in a canyon bathed in the soft glow of bioluminescent fungi. Above them, massive wings of shadow and light cast patterns on the canyon walls. A realm of ancient dragons that had sworn to protect the secrets of the Silver Palace. The dragons, with eyes that glowed like dying embers, acknowledged Roisin's presence and allowed her passage through their sanctum. In the final leg of the Enchanted Odyssey, the leprechauns led Róisín to a mountaintop where the air was thin and the moon felt within arm's reach. The summit overlooked a cosmic tapestry, a celestial panorama that spanned galaxies and nebulae. The leprechauns, with solemn expressions, handed Róisín a silver key, the key to unlocking the mysteries of the cosmos. As she turned the key in an unseen celestial lock, the mountaintop transformed into an observatory surrounded by star-studded skies. Telescopes crafted from moonbeams pointed towards distant galaxies, and the leprechauns recited celestial hymns that echoed through the cosmos. Róisín, with the key in hand, peered through a telescope and glimpsed constellations that revealed the interconnectedness of all things. With the Odyssey complete, the leprechauns and Róisín returned to the Silver Palace, their hearts and minds brimming with the wonders of the mystical journey. The celestial energies of the moonlit Odyssey had woven an intricate tapestry of cosmic tales, and Róisín, now a bearer of the silver key, held within her the wisdom of the enchanted realms. The revelry within the Silver Palace continued, but Róisín, forever changed by the Odyssey, stood at the heart of the celestial hall, her eyes reflecting the mysteries of the moonlit allure. The Silver Palace had become a nexus of magic and cosmic wisdom, and Róisín, with the key in hand, was poised to unlock the secrets that spanned the universe. The Enchanted Odyssey had set the stage for the culmination of Roisin's journey into the heart of the woodland enchantment. Chapter 4, Confluence of Hearts. As the ethereal Odyssey unfolded, Róisín, bearing the silver key and the cosmic wisdom it symbolized, returned to the heart of the Silver Palace. The celestial energies of the moonlit allure lingered within her, a pulsating resonance that connected her earthly existence to the cosmic wonders she had witnessed. The woodland spirit, though unseen, seemed to echo in the whispers of the night. The leprechauns, aware of the profound transformation within Róisín, gathered in a semicircle, their eyes reflecting both mischief and reverence. The Silver Palace, bathed in the soft glow of moonlight, awaited the culmination of Róisín's journey, a confluence of hearts that would bridge the earthly realm with the mystical forces that bound the cosmos. In the center of the celestial hall, a pool of liquid silver materialized, mirroring the celestial tapestry overhead. The leprechauns, with an unspoken understanding, gestured for Róisín to approach. As she stepped towards the liquid silver, the reflections of stars and constellations shimmered beneath its surface. With the silver key in hand, Róisín touched the surface of the liquid silver. The pool responded with ripples that echoed through the hall, as if the very fabric of the cosmos acknowledged her presence. The leprechauns, their eyes gleaming with anticipation, formed a circle around her, creating an ethereal gateway through which the unseen forces of the woodland enchantment would converge. The woodland spirit, drawn by the cosmic resonance, materialized at the edge of the liquid silver. His eyes, ancient and knowing, met Róisín's with a silent acknowledgement. In that moment, the pool of liquid silver became a mirror, reflecting not only the celestial tapestry, but also the intertwining of mortal and ethereal destinies. As Róisín raised the silver key, a surge of energy emanated from its intricate design. The cosmic forces responded, weaving an intricate dance that connected the earthly realm with the vast expanse of the cosmos. The liquid silver transformed, revealing a spectral bridge suspended between the silver palace and the heart of the enchanted forest. The leprechauns, with their mischievous grins, beckoned Róisín to step onto the spectral bridge. As she did, a myriad of visions unfolded. Ancient spirits, celestial beings, and mystical creatures gathered along the edges of the bridge, acknowledging the convergence of realms. The woodland spirit, his silhouette bathed in moonlight, walked beside her, becoming a bridge between the unseen forces of the forest and the cosmic wonders beyond. The bridge led Róisín through moonlit archways adorned with constellations. Each step resonated with the heartbeat of the universe, and the air hummed with the harmonies of celestial spheres. The leprechauns, with ethereal lanterns in hand, accompanied her, casting a soft glow that illuminated the path ahead. As they traversed the celestial bridge, the boundaries between the earthly and ethereal realms blurred. Róisín glimpsed landscapes that mirrored the dreamscape of the enchanted forest. Silver lakes reflecting cosmic constellations, meadows adorned with stardust, and mountaintops that touched the very edges of the cosmos. The woodland spirit, his presence a guiding force, led Róisín towards the summit of a celestial mountain. At its peak, a cosmic gate unfolded, a gateway to realms unknown, where starlight intertwined with the breath of ancient deities. The silver key, pulsating with cosmic energy, unlocked the gate, and Róisín stepped through, transcending the boundaries of mortal existence. On the other side of the cosmic gate, Róisín found herself in a celestial garden, where the stars themselves bloomed like flowers. Spirits of forgotten constellations danced in a cosmic ballet, and the air carried whispers of timeless tales woven into the very fabric of the universe. The woodland spirit, having guided her through the cosmic gate, revealed his true form, a silhouette of pure starlight. His eyes, radiant with the wisdom of eons, met hers, and the confluence of their hearts echoed through the cosmic expanse. The leprechauns, with a final twirl of their lanterns, returned to the Silver Palace, their ethereal laughter lingering in the cosmic winds. As Róisín and the woodland spirit embraced within the celestial garden, the cosmic forces converged, creating a symphony of light and sound that resonated through the realms they traversed. The Silver Palace, now a beacon of cosmic energy, pulsed with the harmonies of the confluence of hearts. The cosmic bridge slowly faded, and Róisín and the woodland spirit found themselves standing at the threshold of the celestial gate. The visions of celestial wonders, ancient spirits, and mystical realms dissipated, leaving them surrounded by the familiar moonlit aura of the enchanted forest. The woodland spirit, his form now a silhouette within the moonlit shadows, nodded in acknowledgement. Róisín, bearing the cosmic wisdom and the silver key that bridged mortal and celestial realms, returned to the heart of the Silver Palace. The leprechauns, having witnessed the confluence of hearts and the cosmic odyssey, greeted her with knowing smiles. The liquid silver pool, now calm and reflective, mirrored the celestial tapestry above. The revelry within the Silver Palace resumed, but a profound serenity infused the air. Róisín, forever bound to the cosmic wonders she had experienced, became a custodian of the confluence of hearts, a bridge between the earthly realm and the celestial mysteries. With the moon shining its glittering light over the Silver Palace, Róisín and the wood spirit assumed the role of perpetual defenders of the woodland's enchantment. Beyond the realms of mortal comprehension, the cosmic odyssey had left an enduring imprint on the center of the enchanted forest, a mark that pulsed with the cosmic energies of the Silver Palace and the union of hearts that had permanently changed Roisin's destiny and the realms beyond.